Welcome to All My Ideas. Today we are going to discuss about the common clinical manifestation or clinical presentation of a patient with a suspected liver disorder. In patients mostly with a liver disorder, it is not necessary to have the symptom or sign like a jaundice, or otherwise we can say a substantial percentage of patients with liver disorders may not have jaundice. It means that near about 60-70% of the patient with chronic liver disease may usually have only mild or a non-specific or trivial symptoms. The symptoms may be something like that, the symptoms of a common cold or a common flu, or a symptomatology like that of a allergic rhinitis. On observing our patient, the symptoms may be unexplainable weakness or great fatigability or malaise, and some of our patients may having with the constitutional symptoms like anorexia, nausea and vomiting. PC of our patient may be loss of taste or loss of smell. If it is because of any mild or moderate form of infection, there may be fever, mostly a mild or moderate fever only. On palpating the abdomen, you can feel there may be a tender abdomen, especially in the right hypochondria. Other GIT symptoms may be like that of our allospodophyllum and sulfur, or bryonia or nexomica, that is alternate diarrhea or constipation. The patient always wants to go to stool, but he cannot, or he has to strain much more. Or in some other patient, they may lose their control over the anal sphincters, and the symptoms may be like that of diarrhea or symptoms of podophyllum. Something like that, GIT problem may predominant in most of our patients. In other set of patients, the symptoms may be like that of a case of influenza. Patient may complain of the symptoms of our gelsemium, rustox, bryonia, eupatorium, etc. That is sore, lame, bruised feeling all through the body as if beaten. That is a symptom of arthralgia or myalgia or muscle pain. Some of our patients may complain with unexplainable weight loss also. In acute hepatitis or moderately active hepatitis, the symptoms will be usually diarrhea, fatigue, loss of appetite, mild fever, muscle or joint pains, nausea and slight abdominal pain, mostly in the right upper quadrant of right hypochondrium, then vomiting. As the case advances, the patient may complain of a brownish or dark color of urine. And the patient may complain with dizziness or drowsiness. That means he become more and more tired. On palpation, there may be hepatomegaly or hepatosplenomegaly can be observed, especially in alcoholic patients. Along with that, our patient may complain of headache or dizziness or nausea, and the skin symptom of our patient may be itchy skin, itching of the skin. While inquiring in a closely observed patient, the PC may be about his bowels. That means about the stool. It may be a very light colored or a pale stool, or it may contain sometime blood or pus. And on examination of the skin or mucous membrane or the sclera, you may get some yellowish discoloration. So, please keep in mind, in most of our patients with liver disorders may not have the expected symptoms. Our patient may be a asymptomatic patient or symptomless patient, or even though there is symptoms, the symptoms are very, very non-specific or subtle or even subclinical. So only by a very keen observation, clean interrogation, clean analysis and evaluation of the symptoms, then only we may get a clue regarding whether the symptoms belongs to the hepatobiliary insufficiency. The symptoms of jaundice can be categorized as: number 1, prodromal symptom or pre-icteric symptom; number 2, icteric symptom; and number 3, post-icteric or a stage of recovery symptoms. Let us see. In a patient with a jaundice, as you know, there are so many causes, and jaundice is only a symptom, or it may be only a sign, various causes, something like that. The symptoms also varying from patient to patient. Anyway, let us see what may be the symptom of a patient with a pre-icteric or prodromal status of jaundice. As we mentioned earlier, mostly our patient will complain of fatigability, malaise, and constitutional symptoms like anorexia, nausea, and vomiting. Fever with a upper abdominal pain or tenderness, with a bowel disorders, as we mentioned earlier, alternate diarrhea or constipation. And there is a specific symptom on keen inquiry. Your patient will say he were having a brownish discoloration of urine 2 days before the onset of jaundice. That means urine is very concentrated, high colored, like a tea or coffee colored urine may be the symptom. And after this, influenza like a fever, abdominal pain, muscle pain or muscle cramps with the bowel disorders, this set of pre-icteric or prodromal symptoms may disappear or it may get vanished. In icteric phase, you can see there is clearal or generalized jaundice. That means the white portion of our eyes, that is sclera. The sclera may be, seems to be very yellowish with a generalized yellowish tinge of the skin in the mucocutaneous junction or over the nails, etc. can be seen, and the spread of the yellow discoloration is very rapidly for several days to week. And there is increased right upper quadrant tenderness or right upper quadrant pain, or there may be some sort of discomfort or a sore feeling or a heavy feeling in the right upper quadrant or right hypochondria. Along with the yellowish sclera or yellowish mucocutaneous junction or a yellowish tongue or yellowish nails, you can see there is, on palpation, there is hepatomegaly or a splenomegaly or hepatosplenomegaly very occasionally. And on close observation, you can see there may be slight lymphadenopathy, and this icteric phase usually varying from 1 week to 4 weeks. In post-icteric phase, the constitutional symptoms of jaundice getting relieved or symptoms may disappear, and at the same time you can see the liver may be enlarged or there may be a positive still hepatomegaly with abnormal LFT can be seen. And this post-icteric or a recovery phase may range from, and it is variable, from 2 weeks to 12 months. That means the post-icteric phase varying from the type of infections or a degree of pathology. So it is usually varied from 2 weeks to 12 weeks, that means up to 3 months. And it is the post-icteric phase is more prolonged in, especially in hepatitis B and hepatitis C viral infections. And keep in mind the complete biochemical recovery, or it can expected 1 to 2 months after the all cases of HIV and HCV infection, and 3 months in HBV infections. Keep in mind, in hepatitis B viral infections, along with the jaundice or constitutional symptoms, the main PC of our patient along with jaundice in hepatitis B viral infection, arthralgia and urticaria-like symptoms are also present. That means joint pains with the itching of the skin. There may be tender hepatomegaly and splenomegaly. One more characteristic symptom of patient with jaundice, especially with hepatitis B infection, the PC of your patient may be, he is having distaste of tobacco smoke. He may having habit of smoking, but now he feels distaste of the same. So depending on the type of infection, the prodromal or pre-icteric, icteric and post-icteric phase varying from person to person depending on the type of viral. So we have to screen our patient at least up to 3 to 6 months even after a recovery of jaundice.